Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Creeper World 4. That is right, we are back yet again in the Galani section, yet again for the other half of the Conquest series. It's time for the Creeper Conquests, number 5. They are finding Titan units. This be allowed. Now, this is apparently very hard packed, so let's get it going. Don't really know exactly what to do, but we don't start with any units, which is interesting. Gobbledygook. The humans are finding Titan units. This cannot be allowed. We must stop them. On the bright side, the assault on their homeworld is going perfectly. Soon they shall be cleansed. Oh my, oh my. So as you can see, this is the map that we had just done starting over here. Definitely it looks a little bit different. They got urns. We never got urns. That's all I'm saying. It's kind of a, you know, a little bit of a shame. Wish we got some urns. The factory is right in the center, which is kind of nice if we can get rid of it. And we have that big emitter over here that, of course, is very well protected. It's got the shields that I never used because I didn't really feel a need to, because we were using our radon for other things. And then it's got just missiles. It's got snipers. It's got all sorts of things. It's got all sorts of things. Now, we are starting over here as just a pile of creep. So let's use that to our advantage, right? Let's just grab some more creep out of it. We only have 2 power, but we can hopefully snag that pretty easily. Probably want to turn things to crimson once we reach a little bit further, because obviously there are snippers there. Oh my. Someone's staying a little bit low. Let's give it a go, though. This should easily turn on the emitters, which should just keep pushing forward, right? Hopefully. There we go. We just want more creep, more creep, more creep. We have a standard array of old standard pack things, so that's very, very nice. And once we get past this sprayer, I think I'm going to want to crimsonate. Also move up the emitter, right? We want to crimsonate and move up the emitter. So we'll probably move both of these, I suppose. Buzzinga bazanga, and there we go. We got that. We got the crimson on this side. That should help out as well. Once we grab this power, we're going to go for that power, and then we're just going to see. We're just going to see. We're going to play it by ear. And we have things that we can do. We have things that we should do. I don't know what's what. But thankfully, with the crimson tub, we're able to get through this. Of course, once we get through this, we want a non-crimsonate, because, yeah, I mean, there's sprayers there. And sprayers suck. Sprayers suck. You suck, sprayer. But that's going to give us a power. That's going to let us keep moving, and hopefully... come on, power. There we go. That should hopefully get us our tower down. So now we need more power. I want to get this. This would be a nice little emitter as well. So we're gonna work on power. We're gonna work on things. I'm gonna leave one emitter up, I think. Leave two for now. I'll leave two. I want 2 launchers, and I want them along like the back edge to fire simultaneously. I do wish we had the hold fire option. I do love the hold fire option. But we are going to be going out of location, and we are going to be going straight for that power. I don't see any snipers along the way. So yeah, let's just keep things going. Again, our goal is... there's a lot of goals right now, right? We want to get power. We want to free this. We want to free this. I mean, there's a lot of things we have to do. We unfortunately don't have all the tools to do it. I mean, we have the tools to do it, we just don't have the power to do it yet, I should say. So we do need to keep things spread. And yeah, I'm just gonna... oh, there goes the Blobulons. So let them go. And you know, I'm gonna take both of these and now say, go to Sporeville and land like Rotlar. Rotlar. Hopefully, again, just trying to get a little bit more power here and there, a little bit more here, a little bit more there, while spreading. I am tempted to go very heavy into launchers at some point. You know, I mean, we could probably take this with just blobs, right? But we're making some progress on this side. As you can see, there's no missiles to stop these spores over here. So the goal is to just take... there it goes. Take this out with spores and... not activate these sprayers, because I clearly don't want that area for the enemy, of course. But hopefully 2 is enough. We may need a third, and that's what's spooky to me. Although, is there any sniper over here? I don't actually see a sniper. So, oh, look at them raining on me. Oh, butts. We were doing so well. I may actually be able to do that just with Blobulons, you know? We may be... Oh, no, there is a sniper there. There is a sniper there. It's right there. Ah, butts. It is dying, though. So, as long as I... Oh, I did send the blobs. I did send the blobs. And, of course, this area is just being completely trapped by that rain. So, and now that's going to heal up even more because I swapped that to blobs. It actually healed up almost completely. Yay! Go me! So I'm gonna add a third launcher. I'll put it like right here. Hopefully that's far... Oh, that might not be far enough away, but we don't have the creep! Of course. Spore at a location. Right there. It being on a separate timer is actually a good thing for us, oddly enough, because that will... let's just see what happens. Do you get shot down? If you get shot down, I will need to move you. Oh my gosh, this is, all right, let's times two it while we're trying to get one more freaking power. It gets... Oh! Where's it going? Wait, I said go... Oh, the... Butts to me. Apparently I misclicked it over here. Oh, it's at random. Use it to random. There we go, location. This should get us the power. Again, we are getting the power. If I didn't swap it to blobs, we would have had it by now. And that is getting shut down. So you are completely useless to us. But that being said, we do have plenty of a mission going on our side, which is great. Ow. Jeez, that thing is still so loud. I did turn down my game sound, so it shouldn't be as loud. Just one little health, and of course all of these are going down. And honestly, I really need creep over here, so if I am going to take this with Blobulons or something along that effect, I need creep in the back. So this is actually as bad as can be for us right now, because yeah, this isn't turned on. Did we get the power? Did we get it yet? There we go, we did it, boys. Let's just reset. Let's reset our creep, grab some more. There we go, another creep going down. Another one going down. Loads of creep coming out now. That's just gonna be able to flow exactly where we want it to go. We're gonna easily surround this. Once we take that tower, we should be in a really good spot. I'll use a field gen. Push into the tower, which will also push the AC away, because it's not a virtue field gen, which means this now runs out of power, those are out of power. We've made progress. We've actually made some progress on the map. Holy moly, it happened. It was bound to happen eventually, but we finally did it, right? We finally did it. Gosh, that is annoying. Oh, that sound. It hurts. That's okay. It's okay. Pain happens. Pain does happen, and it is right in all of our emitters. I was kind of hoping it would be over here, but, you know, beggars can't be choosers. We just have to deal with it every time it crops up. AC is already spreading everywhere. It spread to this. It spread to the tops, so we can't really stop the AC flow right now. If we could stop it from getting to the other side, that would be quite nice, but for now, I think our big goal is just getting into this zone, right? I'm actually shocked that... That one didn't turn on. Don't really care about this one, so I'm not going to worry about that. I am going to field gen and just say, get your butt in gear. Get in there. Start destroying things. Once we take out the sprayers, of course, we can swap over to some Crimzone, and that will also help us take the thing? The dome emitter. That's what it is. It's a dome emitter. Emitting into the dome, you can see with the field gen going, with the crimson, with the mesh, you know, we got a lot of things going for us to take this. Feels pretty good right now. We even have a stash that's filling up, which is awesome. Bad for business. Hmm. get that. Ooh, that's actually not so bad for business because we've already progressed past that point. Oh, that is a lovely, lovely thing when you progress, like, past a point. Plus, we can put that there, say Field Gen in there, move our Crimson further forward, and that should free our friendo. Bazinga Befriendo. Thank you very much. We got you. Okay, good, 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 good. We do have a lot of AC to deal with, but the only AC we can deal with, right? I mean, that's just, we just need some creep to deal with it. That's fine. Now the question is, where do we move from here? I mean, we clearly want this. We want over here as well. There really isn't that much in the way of missile defense, so we could potentially like start in the corner and work our way out. I almost feel like that's what you're supposed to do. We could cut off. If we cut off here, I believe... oop, not either. Whoops-a-daisy. Let's go to the hover pads. This... Okay, so this is connected. So we need to take out this side. And... So if we take out this pylon, this pylon, this pylon, we get the center, right? We don't actually have to take the center. We just get it. So that's actually pretty exciting. And then... This side, if we take out this pylon, actually, if we take out this pylon and this pylon, just those two, we take out this whole side, right? So how do we do that is the question. Now, we do have 6 power, which is not bad. We now have the super unit, which is good. I do want to start reclaiming some of my power as well. So let's see, we have 5 power. If we were to get 5 spores, for instance, right, we could probably spore, like, this tower down. Not too bad, right? We take this out, that knocks this power out. We still have to deal with this one. There's so many that are right there. I was going to say, we can't necessarily blob it. We can't... it's going to be rough. How's the best way to do this? This is actually a little tricky, because, I mean, I would love to just move in on it. But again, I don't feel like we have the power to do that quite yet. We have 3 missile launchers over there, which is quite annoying. We could potentially grab another power just with spores, right? We could easily spore that. There's, like, no missile launchers. Or there's... Actually, there's a couple right there. Never mind! Let's just place down some... Let's place down some launchers and see what's going to happen. Let's just do... 1... 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, if we do that, they all turn on. Good. So now we have 5 spores. Well, let's send them out of location. And we can just see, right? If we send all 5 right there, do any make it? Step 1. Right? Again, this is all experimentation at this point. Who is to know for sure? Not I, that's for sure. I definitely don't know at this point. Okay, Bazinga. We lost 1. Lost 2. And... Okay. We lost 3. But the other 2 have landed. And they should actually be able to take that out. So that's a good sign. Right? There's that. Which also means these commands will be taken out. I mean, we'll be, you know, run out of power. Oh, no, they're not going to run out of power. Okay. So the question is, can we take this one out? And I doubt it? But I'm curious. No. Okay, so we can take that one out. We can't take that one out. It's a little bit of a shame. We can just move out with... blobs, like we can just start blobbing things, and that wouldn't be too terrible. But again, they have 3 snipers there, and that's what's spooky to me, is those 3 snipers. Ooh, let me take this out. That's a different story, because we can take this out. It's close, but it might... Oh no, there's one there. Holy moly, they got taken out so fast. Because all 4 go, and then, yeah, they're right next to the factory. Okay, planning going awry. That's okay. Again, snipers are not going to be very good. But that's okay. We can do some Skimmelim, or some Blobulons. Now this should, we should get some kills at least. And with those kills, that should, in theory, move to the sniper. If we get this sniper, we'll be in a pretty good spot. Alright. I guess the plan is just creep. We are just going the creep route, and that's a-okay. I was just trying to avoid. I was trying to be fancy. But sometimes fancy is the problem, right? You're just too fancy for your britches kind of thing. Fancy for the pantsy. And sometimes you just need to go with creep. I didn't want to go with creep. I wanted to be a little bit fancier. And that's a-okay. We're just going to move it on in. Now that being said, we are going to drop something over here eventually just to help out. Of course, Bazinga, if we can start moving these emitters out of the rain, I will be very happy. And yeah, we should be super good. Move these out of the rain. They'll be happy. Emitter. Yeah. You. Much nicer. So now we're in a much better position. We have creep growing, which is what we want to see. We have things going, and we have a method of moving. As you can see, we're just plowing on it at this point. We're just going to take our creep, make them eat it, make them enjoy it, make them love it. We'll even toss down some crimson just to help with that front line, just that wee little bit. And I'm even going to toss down a launcher. Like, I can't put one like inside of it. I was hoping to put one inside, but that's okay. Because all we need is the creep. All we need is that creep. So keep it going. Keep it pushing. And if we can just get all the way through, make it to the other side, like right there, that would be perfect. Like right there. If we can get this active, we should be able to keep pushing with that. So we do this. We do this. We go here. Bazinga. Oh, but stop it! Stop it! We don't want you doing your thing! It's about to just start raining right here, I know. Oh no, it's raining over there! The dream is real! It left our emitters alone! And the creep is working so much better than this, than everything else. Feel a little bit bad about that again. I really did not want to just use creep here, just to be, you know, fancy, I suppose. But yeah, we're just pushing. We're just pushing. That should fill in. That should turn on. There, yeah. And we grab some crimson. We'll fill it in. Take this area out. Work our way to the corner, and then we now have a very good time. I'd say a very good time. I mean, it gets us this area. Should get us another power, I think. Yeah, two more power, which is nice. But the real key is the fact that we do get that prime emitter. Not for the fact that we have the emitter, but more so for the fact that we will indeed have something that's going to be targeted by that every time. Like, that should be the main target of our ire, of the enemy's ire, I suppose. Because that will be... It's just going to fill this up like last time, right? So, thank you, Stash. I definitely needed some creep on this side. Very handy-dandy. And can I activate a launcher right there? That would be amazing if I could. No, that's fine. I think we are in... We're in actually a pretty precarious situation right now. Where we need to actually take out a couple of key units. Taking out that was actually pretty big for us. Because that is going to allow us to finish this push. There we go. Push off to the side. Bazinga! Power's been cut off. This is now dead. This is now dead. We have done it. All we need to do is, there we go. It's now online. They're gonna run out of power. Everyone's happy. Super emitter on the go. This done. Beautiful. Beautiful stuff. And you know, we can even mesh this out, right? We can place a mesh, range two, hopefully. Hopefully this will mesh up. We'll see. Does mesh fill in? It does. So that's gorgeous news, right? We can actually start to mesh out, because there are little walkways that connect, and I definitely want that to be meshed in. Yeah, right there. So we'll just mesh over here, we'll mesh over here, and then we will have the release of the creep, right? We'll bring it out, yeah, as you can see, it's already out on this side. That's huge, huge, huge. It's just loads of creep that's now going to be flowing for us. And we can decide what to do with it. Nice. Okay. So now we're in a much better position. We want to take this out and, like, one of these out. So, how are we doing? So, I think we take this out. We can then actually just spore launch here. I don't really see... I see missiles down here. Right? And I was trying to go for this one. But going for this one... see anything to stop us, right? There's no missiles here. And if we take... I mean, I don't even think we need to take this out. But we want to get this pylon. So if we take this out and this pylon, this area dies. We don't have to worry about the super units inside. We don't have to worry about anything. All we have to worry about at this point in time would be... let's connect that mesh up and keep this mesh going. Beautiful. So yeah, let's take out this side. Boom, boom, boom. Feels pretty good. Mesh going strong. We'll actually increase the range of our mesh so we can make it nice and girthy. Girthy mesh, yes, yes. That's what you want to see. And this is pushing in. Beautiful. And, oh, I forgot, we got two more power, too, which is actually pretty huge when you think about it. It's going to allow us to push that much easier. Grab some crimson, grab, I don't know, field gen? Sure. Let's just toss one down and just say, move your butt, crimson. Nothing matters anymore. The creep is coming. Oh, the boy is the creep coming. This will also get us two more power, which is huge. And then we don't have to, I really don't want to even fight this, right? We just want it to be on our side. As you can see, the creep has made it to the top. That's going to actually activate a crimson crystal of its own, which is even better. Just free crimson. Lovely stuff. You gotta love it. The creep just pouring out, taking out the map. And this mesh can just keep going from the moon. God, it's so loud. It's still so loud. We'll super mesh this up. Again, makes just this nice and girth. Increase the girth of the mesh so it flows just that much better. This side is getting hit pretty hard, but that's a-okay because we've taken out everything that we wanted to. And, oh god, I have 7 power. I don't even think we need to do this with launchers. I really think we could just take this out. But we're doing it with launchers because that's what I said we were going to do. And I really want to do it. So all these spores at a location right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Beautiful. All of those turn on. We still have power to spare, so we can still just mess around. But yeah, I just want to have some fun, right? I just want to have some fun with it. Bazinga, go through the crimson crystal, bring it on down. Oh, it's beautiful. It's all coming up us right now. So... oh, look at that. Yeah, that's just going to easily take that out. It actually, I think that is the better way to do it. Because now, instead of actually fighting to get through the walls and things, we're just done. Right? We're just done. And we have a lot of spores. So I can leave, like, one there. And then, realistically, you know, we could go for, like, the bat. Like, I think these shields stay up forever. Like, they're like perma shields are kind of ridiculous, even if you hit them. But we can kind of mess with some stuff now, right? We can go like one there to get rid of the totems, one there to get rid of a totem. And we can see if one can land in the back and we can get rid of some of its power. And that sounds pretty good to me, right? We get rid of an urn, we get rid of some power. That could be pretty big in the long term. Yeah, look at this. It's beautiful. Oh, no. Oh, well. Of course, some will still get shot down. Oh, no. They were able to... But I thought... Fine. Keep them all there. Apparently, it needs it all there. Feel so... You know, the best laid plans just never seem to work out for me. That's okay. We'll just wait for the main area to be destroyed. We'll keep moving our mesh up. And we'll even keep pushing. So, toss you down. Move your butt in. We got Crimson. We got things. That's still gone. The shield's still going down. And again, power will come out. The sprayers are gonna... Ooh, I don't need that power anymore wrapped up. Sprayers are the only thing that can fight back over here. Same thing over here. Just the sprayers. We're gonna grab that power. We're gonna grab a lot of stuff. It's all just coming up us right now, which again is good for business. We'll put down those, and I definitely want to move my field gen up. Move that field gen up. Give it the most pressure possible, and keep the mesh going. Great. Keep that mesh forward. That way, it's pushing the mesh. It's not just pushing everything else, and that should be pretty huge. Right. That. I'm actually impressed with how well they're holding against that Crimson Wave, but again, the mesh hadn't caught up yet, so I think that's what we needed. The shield is going down over here, which is fine. The factory will last a little bit, but realistically, again, going down. Once that goes down, again, another power. So yeah, we're feeling pretty good. We're feeling pretty good overall. And... Was there... Oh, I guess we got the shield that was there. Oh, that's absorber terrain, though. Oh, Butulons. Okay, so we have some absorber terrain to deal with. This is now dead. It just has to use up everything. And I think what I'm going to do is actually go with blobs and target. Right, let's just swap it up. Let's just kill what we can. It'll feel pretty good. And that should be that. That should be that. We have some more mesh. We have some more emission right in front of them. There we go. Shield is gone. That's all I cared about. And last but not least... Ooh, I forgot we're making damage in the back. Wait, where's my second one? I didn't even think about that. There's supposed to be one over here. It's not the same map. Oh, I feel cheated. Spores. Let's toss one there again. Okay. Want to take out the totems. Totems are always annoying to me. I don't know why. We can literally just spore the base right now. So we have a technically... You know what? Let's just do that. Let's just do that. Right? I mean, if we can, we should. It's just the way that we should do that. Buzzinga. Get an urn power? Let's just toss a launcher down. Make it a spore, put it at a location, send it on the base. Yeah, they'll shoot down one or two. You know? But I mean, honestly, the creep already is, like, in the base, right? We've already sort of surpassed where we need to be. The mesh is going strong from the original point. Oh, that's set to blobs. Let's set them to spores. Thank you. There we go. The mesh is doing great. We've, again, broken into the base for the most part. The field gen can just keep it going now. And, yeah, we are just going straight. Boop. Yeah, they can fight off the spores. But because they come in, like, in a drip style to a degree, they will just over time win. It's just the beauty of that. I mean, look at that. I mean, yeah, they're killing it all. But, yeah, the base is destroyed. Ooh, baby, does that feel good. And this is gone. And, yeah, like, their initial defense already gone. Taken out. Spores doing their thing. Base gone. There we go. All that is... No more power on the map. go to random spores, or not random, no, structures. And we're just gonna clear the map, right? We that's all we want to do left. We just want to fill the map up with lovely creep. Let it flow, let it go, and we'll, you know, get the rest of the power that we can. Thankfully, oddly enough, we do have a creep limit, and we are getting close, so just doing this with creep alone probably would have been pretty difficult when you think about it. Because, yeah, I mean, creep is good, don't get me wrong, but once you hit that limit, like, all emitters are turned off, right? So if we had so much creep stored up back here, that would have been a problem. That would have been a problem, but not anymore, because look at the... Oh my gosh, so many urns now. Launchers. Let's go. All of the launchers. Oh, it's glorious. All of them set to structures. That should also take out the totems now, with this many launchers all activated. Feels pretty good. And yeah, see again, 4.7. Like, we haven't even taken over all the map, and we are about to hit creep cap in essence. So go us. Yep, we hit that one, which is great. There's one totem left, and you know what? I'm just gonna say at a location. I'm just gonna hit it personally. Hit it personally, because it needs to go. It needs to go. Go back to structures. Now it's the time for. There we go. All totems out. All things go down. Creeper cap super hit. I'm not sure if the creep is dying from the spores because it's getting shot. Some of it definitely is, or if it's because if it's at creeper cap, it doesn't. I'm actually surprised there's still ammo in these things, but maybe they're just really effective with ammo. I don't know. But yeah, this the AC is like just holding on. Look at him go though. Look at the fellas. Let's go to location. Let's shoot a bunch over here. Because this is the last bit of AC. It must be cleaned up. Oh, baby. There we go. Oh, yeah. We are actually increasing our creep past 5. But then it goes back down. See? It does go back down. Now, maybe that's from being absorbed. Maybe that's from something else. I don't know. But we have done it. Let's see how well we did. Did it in 30 seconds for the totem, which is standard. And how did we do? 37 minutes, 29 seconds. Not bad, not the best, but I have a better understanding now. 6 minutes, someone knows something, that's for sure. So around 30 minutes is a pretty good time. 20 minutes from Squiggle, though. Go Squiggle. Very, very cool. Yeah, I mean, I feel like it did pretty decent. Definitely tried some things that didn't work. I now have a better understanding. I really wanted the spores and stuff to work in the beginning, but I think how we use them in the end is better. So, yeah, I mean, realistically, once we just use your creep, take out, get free some things. I mean, technically speaking, if we didn't free that and just took out the main base, we could have then worked to free the sides. I don't know. Maybe it would have been better. But, hey, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and all of that good stuff. And I'll catch you next time. Take care.